So next I am going to, in this class, going to discuss the solutions for the questions I have shown you in the previous class. So I am going to discuss the solutions of the questions starting from question number 41 onwards. So again, look at the question number 41. So again, look at the question number 41, which I have shown you earlier. Assertion region, if a bomb is dropped from an aeroplane moving horizontally with constant velocity, appears to move in a vertical straight line for the pilot of the plane. Based on horizontal component of velocity, the bomb remains constant during the motion under gravity, which is same as the velocity of the plane. So here, the both assertion region are true, and region is the correct explanation for assertion. Because once the bomb is dropped from the aeroplane, it moves under influence of gravity. So for motion of the bomb under influence of gravity, the horizontal velocity of the bomb remains constant. So initial loss of the bomb with respect to stationary observer on the ground under for motion under gravity is equal to the velocity of the plane. So in the given question, plane is moving with constant velocity in the horizontal direction. The horizontal component of velocity of the bomb also remains constant, which is same as the velocity of the plane. Therefore, horizontally both the bomb and the plane are moving with equal velocities. Therefore, velocity of the bomb relative to the plane will be in the vertical direction due to influence of gravity. Therefore, for the pilot in the bomb appears to move vertically downwards, similar to a freely falling body. So here the first option will be the answer. Both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. So next I am going to show you the question number 42. A bullet is dropped in from same height. Another bullet is fired horizontally. They will hit the ground. So I have already discussed this in theory part, that in the case of horizontal projection, the time taken to reach the ground is given by capital T equal root of 2h by g. That means when a body is thrown horizontally from certain height h above the ground, the time taken by it to reach the ground is same as the time taken by another body which falls freely under gravity from same height. So both will take same time to reach the ground given by root of 2h by g, because initial loss in the vertical direction is 0 for both the bullets. Therefore, both will reach the ground simultaneously. So second option is the answer. Next, look at the question number 43. An aeroplane, when it is vertically above point A on the ground, drops a bomb which hits the target B on the ground. The plane is moving at a height of 1.96 km from the ground, the speed of 300 meter per second. The distance between A and B is, I am going to solve this problem now. So here the initial velocity of the bomb for motion under influence of gravity is same as the velocity of the plane, which is equal to 300 meter per second in the horizontal direction. The bomb starts moving under influence of gravity from the point O. So the point A lies vertically below the initial position of the bomb. Once the bomb is left from the plane, it moves under influence of gravity in a parabolic path and strikes the ground at the point B. That means the bomb strikes the target at B. So you have to find the horizontal distance from between A and B. That means you have to find the horizontal range of the projectile. The initial height h of the bomb for motion under gravity is 1.96 kilometers. So in the case of horizontal projection, the horizontal range is equal to horizontal velocity into time taken to reach the ground. The horizontal velocity is same as initial velocity of the bomb for motion of gravity, which is equal to 300 meters per second. In the case of horizontal projection, time taken to reach the ground is given by t equal to root of 2h by g. So horizontal range, that is the distance between A and B, can be as u into root of 2h by g. Here u is given to be 300 meters per second, and h is equal to 1.96 kilometers. So we can have to convert into meters. That is 1.96 into 10 cube meters, and g is equal to 9.8 meters per second square. So you get the value of r from this. You get 20 in meters. So you'll get 6,000 meters or 6 kilometers is the answer for the question. So if you want to copy the solution of the problem, you can copy down the solution of the problem. If you need more time to copy the solution of the problem, you can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. So I have just discussed the question number 43. So you get the second option as the answer, that is 6 kilometer. Next I am going to discuss the question number 44. See the question number 44 on the screen. A bomb is dropped from an aeroplane flying horizontally with a velocity of 720 kilometers per hour at an altitude of 980 meters. To what time will the bomb hit the ground? Look at the solution. So the time taken to reach the ground, in the case of, as I discussed earlier, the body is projected horizontally with an initial velocity u from height h above the ground, then the time taken to reach the ground is given by root of 2h by g, which is independent of initial velocity projection. So for motion under gravity, the initial velocity of the bomb is same as the velocity of the plane, which is equal to 720 km per hour in the horizontal direction. So after left from the plane, the bomb moves under influence of gravity in a parabolic path, and the time taken to reach the ground in the case of horizontal projection is given by root of 2h by g. Here h is given to be 980 meters and g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. So you get answer as 10√2 seconds. So that's the answer for the question. So I have just discussed the question number 44. You get answer 10√2 seconds. So if you substitute root 2 equal to 1.414, you get 14.14 seconds. That is second option is answer. Next I am going to discuss the next question. See the question number 45. An aircraft flying horizontally at 360 km per hour releases a bomb at a stationary tank 200 meters away horizontally. What must be the height of the aircraft above the tank if the bomb is to hit the tank? So you see the solution of the problem. So initial velocity of the bomb is same as the velocity of the aircraft, which is equal to 360 km per hour. Means you can write convert into meter per second. 360 into 5 by 8 meter per second. That comes out to be 100 meter per second. Let O be the initial position of the bomb for motion under influence of gravity. From where it begins to move under influence of gravity. Let A be the point on the ground which lies directly below the initial position of the aircraft. Let H be the height of the aircraft. Above the ground, the bomb moves in a parabolic path and strikes the ground at the point B. That means it strikes the stationary tank at the position B. The stationary tank is situated at a horizontal distance of 200 meters. So you are given the horizontal range of the projectile for motion under gravity as 200 meters. The initial velocity for the bomb for motion under gravity is 100 meter per second in the horizontal direction. You have to find H. So the horizontal range, a total horizontal distance covered during motion under gravity, can write U into capital T. Where capital T is the time taken to reach the ground. So this R is given to be 200 meters. The horizontal velocity is of the bomb is equal to the initial velocity for motion under gravity, that is 100 meter per second. So the time taken by the bomb to reach the ground is 2 seconds. In the case of horizontal projection, the time taken to reach the ground is given by T equal root of 2H by G. Or you can write, from same equation you can write H equal to half GT square. That is vertical displacement during motion under gravity, during the time of flight. During the entire motion under gravity can be written as H equal to half GT square. G is given to be 9.8 meter per second square. The time taken to reach the ground is 2 seconds. To simplify this, you get the initial height H of the bomb above the ground is 19.6 meters. So answer is 19.6 meters. So if you want to copy the solution of the bomb, we can copy the solution. You can take a pause. If you need more time to copy the solution, you can take a pause and copy the solution of this problem. So I have just discussed the question number 45. You got second option of the answer, 19.6 meter. Next I am going to discuss the question number 46. Body of mass M thrown horizontally with velocity from the top of the tower of height H touches the level ground at a distance of 250 meter from foot of the tower. Body of mass 2m thrown horizontally with a velocity v by 2 from top of a tower of height h 4h will touch the level ground at a distance of dash meter from foot of the tower. Come on, look at the solution of this problem. So in the case of horizontal projection, the body is projected horizontally from height h above the level ground from the top of a tower of height h. The horizontal distance covered from foot of the tower when it reaches the ground is given by r equal to u into root of 2h by g. I denote the horizontal range in the first case by r1. The initial speed in the first case is equal to v. So r1 equal to v into root of 2h by g. In the second case, the horizontal range in the second case I denoted by r2. That is equal to initial speed in second case into root of 2h2 by g, where h2 is the height from where the body is projected horizontal in second case, and u2 is initial speed of projection. So you can divide r2 with r1. So divide r2 with r1, get u2 by v, root of 2 by g gets cancelled, you get root of h2 by h. The initial speed in second case is given to v by 2, and height h2 in second case is equal to 4h. You can try to simplify this yourself. You get r2 by r1 equal to 1. So r2 will get equal to r1. That means horizontal distance covered in second case, same as the horizontal distance covered in the first case. The horizontal distance covered in the first case is 250 meters. So in second case also it will be 250 meters. So answer is 250 meters. So if you want to copy down the solution of the problem, you can copy down the solution of the problem. In case you need more time to copy the solution, you can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. So we have question number 47. Body thrown horizontally from the top of a tower of 5 meter height, touches the ground at a distance of 10 meters from foot of the tower. The initial velocity of the body is. So in general the body is projected horizontally. So in general when the body is projected horizontally with initial speed u from vertical height h above the ground, then it moves in a parabolic path. The horizontal distance covered when it reaches the ground is given by r equal to u into t, where u is the initial speed of projection or horizontal velocity, which is same as the initial velocity of projection. The time taken to reach the ground in the case of horizontal projection is given by t equal to root of 2h by g. So you are given r equal to 10 meters here with the horizontal distance covered or horizontal range is given to 10 meters and h is given to be 10 meters. H is given to 5 meters, not 10 meters. H is given as 5 meters. G is given at 10 meter per second square. You can simplify this to get the value of u. So you get u equal to 10 meter per second. That is the answer. So for question number 47, which I have just discussed, the answer will be the third option, that is 10 meter per second. Next, let's look at the question number 48. A person in a running train throws a ball, comes into his hands, shows that the train has, third option will be the answer, uniform velocity. Because once the ball is left from the hand of the person, it moves under influence of gravity in a parabolic path as seen by stationary observer on the ground. So the horizontal velocity of the ball will remain constant, equal to the velocity of the train. The train is moving horizontal with constant velocity, then both the horizontal velocity of the ball and velocity of the train will be same at all the instant during the motion of the ball under influence of gravity. Therefore, the ball exactly falls into the hands of the person if the train moves horizontally with uniform velocity. Then you see the question number 49. An aeroplane is flying horizontally at 98 meter per second, releases an object which reaches the ground in 10 seconds. The angle made by its velocity to the horizontal while hitting the ground is. So I am going to discuss this solution is as follow. So the initial velocity of the object, the initial velocity of the object can be taken is equal to the velocity of the airplane, which is equal to 98 meter per second. Let us suppose the object starts moving under influence of gravity from the point O. And A be the point on the ground which lies directly below the point O. So the object moves under influence of gravity in a parabolic path. Let B be the position of the object just before it hits the ground. Let us suppose the velocity of the projectile makes an angle alpha with a horizontal direction just before it hits the ground. As I discussed in the theory of the horizontal projection, so if alpha is the angle with the velocity makes with the horizontal direction at time t after projection, so tan alpha equal to Vy by Vx. So in the case of horizontal projection, the horizontal component of initial velocity same as initial velocity projection. In vertical component velocity at time t during motion under gravity can be written as g into t. That is vertical component velocity, t seconds after it is released. So here the object takes 10 seconds to reach the ground. So to find the angle alpha just before it reaches the ground, you have to take t equal to 10 seconds. G is given as 9.8 meter per second square and U equal to 98 meter per second. So you can simplify this. You get tan alpha equal to 1 or alpha equal to 45 degrees. So answer is 45 degrees. So you can copy the solution of this problem. If you want to copy the solution of the problem, you can copy the solution of the problem. So just now I have discussed question number 49. Second option is the answer for this question. Next, see the question number 50. A passenger in a moving train tossed a coin vertical upwards. The coin falls ahead of him in the direction of motion of the train. The train must be moving with four options are given. Deceleration, acceleration, uniform velocity, none of these. So the coin falls ahead of him in the direction of motion of the train. That means horizontal distance covered by the coin during the motion of the coin under influence of gravity is more than the horizontal distance moved by the train. In case the train moves with uniform velocity in the horizontal direction, then the coin exactly falls into the hand of the passenger. But suppose if the train is moving with acceleration, in that case, the horizontal distance moved by the train by the time coin falls into the train will be more than the horizontal distance moved by the passenger will be more than the horizontal distance moved by the coin. So in that case, the coin will fall behind him. That means the coin falls behind the passenger in the train if the train is accelerating or speeding up. But here it is given that the coin falls ahead of him, which means that the horizontal distance moved by the coin is more than the horizontal distance moved by the passenger. That happens when the passenger is moving with a deceleration or retardation along with the train. Therefore, first option is the answer for this question. So see the question number 51. From the top of a building 80 meters high, the ball is thrown horizontally, which hits the ground at a distance The line joining the top of the building to the point where it hits the ground makes an angle of 37 degrees with the ground. If g equal to 10 meter per second square, find the initial velocity of projection of the ball. So I am going to discuss this problem now. So let us suppose O is the point from where the ball is projected horizontally with initial velocity u, which you have to find. Let A be the point on the ground which lies directly below the initial position A. The ball moves in a parabolic path and strikes the ground at the point B. This height h of the building, that is initial height of the ball above the ground, is given to be 80 meters. So given that the line joining this point O with the point B makes an angle of 37 degrees with the ground. So this is the parabolic path along which the body has actually traveled. This is the imaginary straight line joining the point O with the point B at which the ball strikes the ground, makes an angle of 37 degrees with the horizontal. To find the initial speed u, you have to know the horizontal distance r covered by the ball when it reaches the ground. That means r is the horizontal distance between A and B. Or you can say r is the horizontal range of the projectile during the motion under gravity. So in the triangle OAB, can write tan 37 degrees equal length of the side opposite to the angle 37 degrees. That is h divided by length of the side adjacent to the angle 37 degrees, that is r. Tan 37 degrees, you can take it as about 3/4. H is given to be 80 meters. So you can find the horizontal range r from this. So you get r equal to 80 meter into 4/3. Or r equal to 320/3 meters. So the horizontal distance covered during the motion under gravity, or horizontal range, is given by horizontal velocity into time taken to reach the ground. So the time taken to reach the ground in the case of horizontal projection, same as the time taken by another body that falls freely under gravity from same height h. So you can take h equal to 80 meters here and g equal to 10 meter per second square. You simplify this, the time taken to reach the ground, you will get 4 seconds. So the horizontal range or horizontal distance covered during the motion under influence of gravity, given by r equal to u into t. Here r is, we got the value of r is 320/3 meters, and time taken to reach the ground is, we got as 4 seconds. Can simplify this. So you get the answer as 80/3 meters per second. That is the answer. That is, the initial speed of projection of the ball is 80/3 meters per second. So I have just now discussed the question number 51. So you get the second option as the answer, 80/3 meters per second. Next, look at the question number 52. Body is projected horizontally with a velocity of 20 meter per second from a height of 160 meters above the ground. G equal 10 meter per second square. And at what time after projection, its velocity makes an angle of 30 degrees with a vertical. So here, the initial velocity is in the horizontal direction, which is equal to 20 meter per second. Let us suppose where is the point from where the body is projected horizontally. From a height h equal to 160 meters above the ground. This h is given to 160 meters. Let A be the point on the ground which lies directly below the initial position of the body. It moves in a parabolic path. Let P be the position of the projectile after some time t, at which the velocity v bar makes some angle alpha with the horizontal direction. You have to find the time after which the velocity v bar makes 30 degrees with the vertical. So at a point P in its path, let us suppose at a point P in its path, the velocity v bar makes an angle 30 degrees with the vertical. And alpha represents the angle which the velocity makes with the horizontal. So in the expression for the direction of the velocity of the projectile, in the expression which we discussed in the past for alpha, alpha represents the angle which the velocity makes with the horizontal. So from the figure you can make out that alpha plus 30 degrees is 90 degrees. Therefore, the angle alpha which the velocity makes with the horizontal can be taken as 90 minus 30 degrees, that will be 60 degrees. That means you have to find the time after projection at which alpha becomes 60 degrees. So tan alpha we write Vy by Vx. In the case of horizontal projection, Vy you can write Gt and Vx equal to U. So you have to find the time after projection at which alpha becomes 60 degrees. The velocity makes 30 degrees with the vertical at the instant when its velocity makes an angle of 60 degrees with the horizontal. So alpha should be taken of 60 degrees. G is given as 10 meter per second square. And U is 20 meter per second. You know that the value of tan 60 degrees is equal to root 3. So if you simplify this, you get T equal to root 3 seconds. So that's the answer for the problem. If you want to copy the solution of the problem, you can copy down the solution of the problem. In case you need more time to copy the solution, you can take a pause and copy the solution. So just now I have discussed the question number 52. You get the second option as answer, that is 2 root 3 seconds. Next I am going to discuss the question number 53. Body is projected horizontally with a velocity of 5 meters per second from the top of a tower of height 58 meters, 98 meters. The magnitude of change in velocity 3 seconds after projection is. So here, if you calculate the time taken to reach the ground in the given problem, it will be definitely more than 3 seconds. So in 3 seconds after projection, it will be moving under influence of gravity. So the acceleration of the projectile is equal to the acceleration due to gravity, which can be assumed to be constant at the given place. So in general, if a body has constant accelerated motion, we can write constant acceleration is equal to change in the velocity divided by time interval. So you can write change in the velocity in a given time interval is equal to the constant acceleration multiplied by time interval. So when the body has a constant acceleration in an interval of time, then change in the velocity during that time interval is equal to acceleration into time interval. So magnitude of the change in the velocity is equal to magnitude of acceleration into time interval. Magnitude of the acceleration of the projectile is same as the acceleration due to gravity at the given place, which is denoted by small g, and t is the time interval. You are asked to find magnitude of change in velocity in 3 seconds after projection. And you are given g as 9.8 meter per second square. So you can take t equal 3 seconds. So you get change in velocity for 3 seconds as 29.4 meter per second. So answer is 29.4 meter per second. If you want to copy the solution of the problem, you can copy down the solution of the problem. In case you need more time to copy the solution, you can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. So just now I have discussed the question number 53. So you get the third option as answer, 29.4 meter per second. Next you see the question number 54. At high altitude, a body at rest explodes into two equal fragments, with one fragment receiving horizontal velocity of 10 meter per second. The time taken by the two radius vectors connecting point of explosion to two fragments to make 90 degrees is. So, I'm going to discuss solution of this problem. So here we apply conservation of linear momentum. If the body is initial at rest, so initial momentum is zero. Let m denote the mass of each fragment. So in vector form, let u1 bar and u2 bar denote the velocities of the two fragments just after explosion. So vector sum of the momentum of the two fragments just after explosion can be equated to the momentum just before explosion. Just before explosion, the body is at rest. So initial momentum just before explosion is zero. So resultant momentum just after explosion can be equated to the momentum just before explosion. That means momentum, vector sum of the momentum of the two fragments is zero. So from this you get u2 bar equal to mu2 bar equal to minus mu1 bar. That means at the instant just after explosion, the two parts move in opposite direction with same magnitude velocity. So mod of u2 bar is same as mod of u1 bar. That is equal to 10 meter per second. This problem also comes under one of the special case I have discussed in the theory of horizontal projection. I have discussed a special case at the end of the theory of horizontal projection. In general, if two bodies are projected simultaneously in opposite directions, horizontally, from certain height above the ground, with initial speeds u1 and u2, and the time after which the position vectors or radius vectors R1 bar and R2 bar are perpendicular, each other is given by t equal to 2 into root of u1 u2 by g. Here u1 is 10 meter per second, u2 is also 10 meter per second. G is 10 meter per second square. So in case you remember the conclusion I have discussed in the special case, you can directly get the answer as 2 seconds. But sometimes you may not remember this conclusion, or you may not be able to get the idea that you have to use this result. So therefore I would like to also discuss the alternate method for this question. So I am discussing the alternate method for same question number 54. That is one part the body at rest, the top of the tower explodes in two equal fragments of same mass, then the two parts will have same horizontal velocity in magnitude but in opposite directions. So the one part moves in a parabolic path like this, which I have shown to the right side. The second part moves in a parabolic path on the other side. P and Q denote the positions of the two projectiles after time t. Both the parts cover same vertical distance in a given time t given by y equal to half gd square. The horizontal distance covered by one of the projectiles in a given time t are denoted by x, because the two parts start moving in opposite direction with same horizontal speed of 10 meter per second. Both cover same horizontal distance denoted by x in a given time t, but these horizontal distances are covered in opposite directions. You have to find the time after projection at which the radius vectors or position vectors of the two projectiles are perpendicular, that is r1 bar is perpendicular to r2 bar. So by symmetry of the situation, r1 bar will be perpendicular to r2 bar. Then the angle which the position vector of each projectile makes with the vertical direction is 45 degrees. So we have a right angle triangle. O is the initial position at the top of the tower. Let n be the midpoint of the positions of the two projectiles which lie directly below the initial point. So O n p is a right angle triangle. The same way O n q is a similar triangle, congruent triangle. So angle at O is 45 degrees. So in one of the right angle triangles you can write tan 45 degrees equal to x by y, tan 45 is 1. So you have to find the time after which y equal to x, I mean magnitude of vertical displacement becomes same as magnitude of horizontal displacement. So the angle between r1 bar and r2 bar will be 90 degrees when vertical displacement covered is equal to the horizontal distance covered in magnitude. In the case of horizontal projection, y can be written as half gt square and x can be written as u into t. So magnitude of the horizontal velocity is same for both the bodies, which is equal to 10 meter per second. So t square by t is 2u by g. So the time after which the radius vectors of the two bodies are perpendicular to each other will be 2u by g, where u is the magnitude of the horizontal velocity of each body, which is equal to 10 meter per second. So you get the answer as 2 seconds. So the answer for this question is 2 seconds. So if you want to copy the solution of the problem, you can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem. So in this class I have discussed the solutions of the questions numbering from 41 to 54. So I will be discussing the solutions of the remaining questions numbering from 55 to 60 in my next class.